Alright, welcome to Skip Barber Race Series, Okayama International Raceway, or whatever it is called. My name is Chris, and this is Fox Gaming. Where we are starting in 6th place, I qualified 3rd, and then at the last second, everyone went super fast and just cut way out in front of me. So this was a wild race. I was so super concentrated I did not speak at all during it, and I was also so concentrated I forgot to hit my record for my sound, so there is no microphone sound. So that's why
take it easy, everyone. Have a good race.
That is why I am recording the sound after
take it easy.
The video has been put into place. So the video has been recorded, and this is an after recording microphone session, so I already know how the race is going to turn out, but you don't know how it's going to turn out until after you watch this video, so just enjoy the video and my post-race commentary while it lasts. So, start of the race, got enough fuel. I was just checking to see if the fuel had enough. Sometimes you don't have enough, and sometimes you have way too much. But you can't do anything there, and so the lights come on, they turn red, they turn green, and go. Now.
Green, green, green!
So we get a decent launch. A few other people get pretty bad launch, like the guy off to the right, I mean to the left. This corner is a hectic corner. I start braking a little early,
left
which is a good thing. Those two
clear.
Guys get some contact, minor contact, that is, anyways. I was sitting
clear
there,
on
whoa!
The left.
And this corner always is the worst. But as you can see, I made it through there perfectly fine. I started 6th. I am now 4th. And right now, how I view it, because it hasn't been rendered in full graphical detail, it's just rendering it really quickly. So I can barely even read my screen, but you'll be able to read it nice and clear when it gets fully rendered. So I'm like, which way do I need to go? Which way do I need to go? I take a look down low. I start breaking way early because I don't want to run into anyone. That happened one time, on Circuit de Giles. Whoa! Okay, there. Let's calm down a bit. Let the guy.
The car on your left.
Let the guy on the left take a little peek. I'm being really nice and awesome driver right there. Just held my line, and oh, he's still there. And let's let him look around on the outside. On the inside, and I'm on the outside.
Clear on the left. Left side. Clear on the left.
So there he goes. He takes the position. Which is fine. No harm, no foul. Go around the last corner. Finish the first lap. The guy that I'm passing right now, he got a cutting the course penalty. So I fly underneath this guy. So I thought.
Clear.
And that's my first 1X right there. And so, you know, just get around that corner as nicely as possible. That's the easiest corner to spin out at, if you didn't know. It's the one that sucks the most in iRacing. On that track is that corner that was corner number 2. The worst corner that there is on this track. Because it slopes away from the inside of the turn. Once it does that, and you're turning left and it slopes towards the right, you just have no freaking traction and you just spin out. And it doesn't slope, obviously, but it does have a
car
tiny
right.
bit of a slope.
Clear.
This guy just flies around me. He just slammed on the brakes way late, and I mean that's perfectly legitimate. He didn't cause any problems. I know I'm not doing the best driving line there is, which is perfectly fine. So this is where something happens, interesting happens. Oh, crash! They get together. He gets smacked. Gets flipped around and. There I am, I get involved in it.
Car right, clear on the right.
Unfortunately.
Left side, clear on the left. Left
so,
side.
So, none of my suspension or my engine gets damaged. As you probably have seen in the thumbnail that I posted for the
clear.
Little picture image. He takes a look at the crossover. I get a better drive off than he does. So he kind of just gets stuck there.
Car right.
So, in that accident, I was in 5th place, and I got shoved all the way down to 7th.
Clear on the right.
When this guy passed me.
Car on your left.
And I just did the crossover on him again there as well. He gets the inside line, which is a little bit easier. And then this happens.
Clear.
And they all get in accidents.
Sorry, you guys.
So, because they all get back in accidents, I'm now back in... I'm back in 4th, I believe. I honestly don't know. But that accident kind of helped me. It was kind of a bad accident to have other people involved in because of the person driving that was involved in it, but still. So the two cars in front of me, Sean Reed and Minko Cartanella, I believe is what it is. It's, as I said, it's pretty blurry. Those two are racing, and since those two are racing, they're slower than I am because I'm just driving and catching up. So I catch up to them in the next couple laps. And we have some pretty good racing time to... with each other, so that's just perfectly fine. Sean just had a massive looseness session basically. Or he just gets really loose, but he saves it. But he doesn't lose all that much time. Like 3.5, 3.6 to 1 second. So they're... No, 2 seconds, I'm sorry. Like I said, I can't read it because it's really blurry. So, 2 seconds and 1 second. So, they're about a second apart from each other. All for second place. Yeah, I was in fourth. All for second place is just this massive... this is a 3-car race for second. Yes, I know. This is just a basically a reactionary video to what I've already done, but why not? You need some audio commentary. Or else it would be boring just listening to this. Yeah, I think that would get kind of boring. I mean, some people like it, but I think a lot more people wouldn't like it, so that's why I'm post-race commenting. So I caught up with Sean, less than half a second behind him. So 4, 5, 6 tenths of a second behind him. Which is enough for the draft, which is significant enough for even it to help my battered and destroyed car. A lot of people are a lot faster on me on the last corner, the last two corners, but nonetheless, I am faster than them in some of the other corners. Namely here, even though this is the corner I suck at the most, it is still a corner that I can pretty much just fly around a lot faster than most other people. Generally, but not always. So Sean just overtook Minko, which also allowed me to catch. Sean just goes really sideways there. And obviously that allowed me to catch up to them. So I'm just in the draft, using the draft to help.
The car on your left.
So I brake way early, just so that way I don't crash anyone.
Clear on the left.
And I just slammed on the brakes there, just to make sure that Sean does not run me over, because he was going to cut the corner and try to cut me off, which would have crashed him, and possibly took me out as well. So I'm being the nicer guy, the better driver. I'm not saying he's a bad driver, I'm just saying the better racer. I basically just... killed my time so that way he wouldn't crash and kill me. And he has a pretty decent connection, a couple blinks here and there, but nothing too bad. And so I just coast around the corner, letting him get back up there. And because I know they're going to race each other more when they do that. Since he got a massive power slam, I got a decent run off of him, and so that enables me to pass him, and he brakes somewhat early.
Clear, car on your left.
There we go,
he bumps
me.
Clear on the left.
And then he passes me on the left, but...
Right side.
He passes me on the right, I'm on the left. I don't know what
Clear on the right.
But that puts me right behind Minko. And I take the inside. He goes a little wide.
Car on your left.
Allows me to come drive up on him.
Clear on the left.
Which kills his run, but not too badly. So that enables me to get a decent half a second in front of him, but he now has the draft with a perfectly clean car, I'm assuming. Actually, I know, but I'm just so...
Car right. Clear on the right.
Oh no, he flips.
Thank you.
And there he goes. So obviously, since you did not see any of the green verbiage on the top of the screen, that means that I did not touch him. So you cannot blame that on me, but you can. because I didn't touch him. He was looking on the inside, and I was up high. And I started to cut down all over in front of him, so he had to hit the brakes. Now, since there was no contact, you can't blame that on me, but morally, you can blame it on me, because if I didn't cut down on front of him, he wouldn't have been in the accident. But then again, you never know, because Sean, he has been bumping and touching me and Mingo a lot. So, as for that, we don't know what would have happened if I wasn't there in that race, but we do know that you can and can't blame it on me. So it's kind of half my fault, half not my fault, because I didn't touch him, but still, I was there. So you can logically argue some things, but you can't argue about a lot of the things. Yeah, I wasn't there, but I was there, but I didn't touch him. Because I didn't touch him, it wasn't my fault. But then again, I was there, so just being there could label me being my fault, but whatever. Just checking the fuel, see if, you know, the fuel is still accurate, and it is, so don't worry about the fuel. And I'm sitting here trying not to scratch myself all over because I got mosquito bites on my back, on my legs, on my arms, and it's just driving me crazy right now, and I'm surprised I can commentate this well. I don't know if I'm commentating well anyways. But I do know that they are driving me crazy, and I'm doing everything I can to ignore them talking, and I took that corner way too badly, but impressively, I still got a run off of Sean, because it was 4.7 and then it went to 5.5. So I gained some. I usually do pretty decent on those, not hairpins, but those are hairpins. I'm going to call those hairpins. Whoa, what happened there? I don't even know if I got that. No, I didn't get that. So right now I'm in second, about 23 seconds. If anything interesting happens, I'm going to just skip to that part, and I'll just kind of go from there, so I'll see you in a few seconds. So, if I remember correctly, there is nothing that else happens that is worth noting in this part of the race, so this next lap, I'm just going to let you enjoy the wonderful music of the Skip Barber Race Series Formula cars. And so just, I'm going to shut up for this next lap, and I'm just going to let you listen to the beautiful sounds. We'll be right back.
You've got
done.
5 laps to go.
I have 5 laps left. If I recalled correctly, there's nothing else of note, as I think I've said before, that happens in the rest of this video of me just racing. So I will skip to the last lap, and there I will then show you the last lap, and then I'll show you what happens, or what had happened from other people's perspectives in the race, such as accidents and stuff like that. So I will see you guys then. I will see you guys then. Sorry, I just ate something. I'm a little bit gassy. Okay, so for the final two turns on the second to last lap, I would just like to join you guys back again for the last lap and then the race recap summary at the very end. One thing that is, I think, somewhat important to note, that despite my damaged car, Sean Reed, the person who was right behind me when Minco Cartonello went upside down in that accident, I think on lap 9, he has went down 21 seconds behind me through damage or just bad driving, or I'm a better driver than he is, per se. I don't know, but there is another person right behind me on my tail that has basically taken Sean Reed's place, and that is Richard Covington. He got down to about 3 seconds behind me and couldn't catch me because the race just ended. The race was too short. If the race went on for any longer, he probably would have caught me. I would have finished third. Now, still, I might crash, and who knows. So, from the looks of it, I'm going to finish second, and he's going to finish third, but things could change in one of these last very few corners. Because this is another common corner I usually spin out on right here, and then this next corner I usually make a mistake. And then I usually spin out on the next corner after that. So, let's just bite the tongue and see who makes it across the finish line in second. Oh, 6.97 seconds. Oh, he just had a massive boost wobble, so 7 seconds behind me. 6.97.
I want to do another lap.
And Minko, he was wanting to go out because he was lapped. He was getting repairs done on his car. And he wanted to go on in the next lap, but the leader didn't let him, was a little bit too fast for him. So I finished second place. And due to that, that
all
was...
Alright, there's the chicken flag.
That was an awesome run for me.
Great job, you did really well.
Because I got second place in Skippy, in a Skippy race, and I had damage. I had a damaged car. I don't know yet to the extent of how bad I did. So because of that, I'm like, oh my... awesome. Oh my god, I did so awesome. I got second place. I was so ecstatic because I got second place. And so let's see how bad it was. And I'm just skipping back to lap one of the race. And then let's just look at the race. That guy had a bad restart. The guy in the red, he got a little bit of contact. I drove around him. Everyone got through turn one cleanly, which usually does not happen. My thumb is driving me crazy because that's where it itches the most. Stupid mosquito bites. Stupid skeeters. So, yeah, pretty cleanly. There's a little bit of contact with the blue and the green car on the very right at the bottom of the screen. Just chopper view instead of blimp view because you can't see anything. Back to the blimp. And let's see from there what happens next. Ah, oh, my freaking thumb! And my back. And my leg. And my left shoulder blade. They all hitch. It's all driving me crazy. So I had to back off there because he was going to basically cut me off. He gets around me on the right. And just look how nicely I go around this corner, allowing him room. Like, we were side by side, and we just, you know, I gave him all the room he needed. And then some, so faster in the corner, broke later, but he was just, didn't have to worry. He blinked, and then he tapped me, which is how that worked. I didn't get no contact from that. He just, I think he slammed on the brake a little bit too hard, got pretty loose sideways. That isn't my fault, though. I didn't intend for that to happen. I'm just checking to see others. Come back to me, that guy, and I'm like, wait, why is that guy so far behind? Right here, he cuts across too much of the rumble strip, the banking, and you can just see him just pull off to the side and just slow down, so just giving some of that time back, and then I come up and I pass him. I go, hello. So there's that. I shall proceed to skip to the next portion of the race in which there is an accident or something of interest to note, so I'll be back in a second. Second lap, lap two, this happens. This guy's getting a little bit of contact, and then a little bit more contact. Get smacked around by that guy, and I run straight into them. There's nothing I can do about it. I mean, let's see if I do it from my view, because I don't remember if I did it from my view or not. So just slow motion. They just come around the corner. And the red guy is already spinning out. Hits the purple guy, gets spun completely around, and I have basically nowhere to go. If we go back and watch it with the bumper views, I'll be able to see exactly what happened. But, as you know, I don't have any freaking front of my car. I have the tires. Like, nothing of the suspension or the drive system actually got affected. It was just literally the nose cone that got destroyed and ripped off the front of the car. I might have got a little bit of suspension damage, but not enough to reasonably affect my driving in any way, shape, or form. Because I basically plowed nose to nose in the guy that I ran into. It was nose to nose, just destruction. So I didn't get too bad of damage other than front big giant gaping hole, which actually keeps my feet a lot cooler. And then lap three, we get to this little incident. I'm trying to find the right one. This guy got hit, and that's why I went to him. Nope, not this one. Same lap. Here we go. So here's what actually happened to this guy. Or, I was seeing what actually happened. So, this guy, he just goes around the corner. And he just gets loose. And so he actually doesn't get any damage, but then he does this. And then he kind of stupidly drives into it. I'm not saying he's stupid, I'm not saying he's a bad driver. He just, like, didn't realize that the guy was backing up. And that's basically what happened. It was just kind of stupid. And let's look from the top, I mean. He comes around and just gets sideways. He already has a little bit of front end damage because he doesn't have the little wing on the front, but he stops in the middle of the track. That guy touches him, that guy gets turned around, and then, like, he just drives into that guy. So, I mean, that was kind of a stupid accident on his part that he created. Nothing, you know, anyone else could have done about it, but just going back to me, I think I'm going to skip forward here shortly, so I'll get back to you when I see something of further interest to any of the viewers, so I'll be back in a second. Alright, so the situation with the guy in the red number 8 machine getting sideways and rolling is going to happen soon. John Reed barely taps my tire, and so that's how I got around him. And so we're just driving around, James Reed goes to the outside, tries to make it 3 wide if it was anywhere in a significant line. So I'm just doing a chase, and you can't see anything from the chase view. So here's a rear chase. And from his point of view, just starts turning. I start coming down to make the corner. Obviously had room to clear him, and he just slams on the brake, gets hit, turns sideways, and just rolls. And there he loses the little wing on the front. I don't think he gets too significant much of a damage. He's got some rear left wheel suspension damage, but nothing too terribly bad considering that he just rolled a few times. So yeah, just really quickly, nothing happens. Lap 12. Lap 13. So here's just the last lap by myself. Watching my beautifully trashed car, Skip Barber Formula 2000 car, just drive around the track at Okayama for the last lap. And you can see how far behind me the other guy was. He wasn't that far behind. You'll be able to see him this next camera angle. There you go. So he's not that far behind me, but he's far enough behind that I don't have to really worry about him. And so last 1, 2, 3, 4, last 4 corners of the track. The decent corner. Decent corner, decent drive off. I could have drove off a little bit better on that one. Flew around that corner pretty well. Down. I usually downshift to second, and I didn't do it on that corner, so you heard the downshift to second in the middle of right about there where that guy just turned on. And race is done, so there is the race recap. I know I missed a few things. I'm not perfect, so you saw what I saw, what I could remember, what I could find, and well, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.